Department of Television and Radio at Brooklyn College presents to you Let's Talk Sports with your host, Justin Holmes. Today's topic is body enhancement in the world of professional wrestling.
Hey, Brooklyn, what's up? I'm going to start the show with a good fact. According to Keith Pinkard, a medical examiner in Dallas who has followed wrestling fatalities, wrestlers have death rates about 7 times higher than the general U.S. population. They are also 12 more times likely to die from heart disease than other Americans aged 22 to 44. Now, here to discuss the dangers of this sport is former wrestler Spedekate Valsamus. Y'all like that name, right? Spedekate Valsamus.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Pleasure to be here.
Oh, that's quite a shake right there.
Thank you.
Spedekate, does it bother you that your career choice is notorious for drug abuse, steroids mainly?
No. Not every wrestler does drugs. For most wrestlers, it's kind of a choice they make, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, but the industry doesn't really push anybody to do steroids. Like, Vince McMahon doesn't come up to you and tell you, hey, buddy, you got to take steroids, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Yeah.
It's just pressure.
There's a lot of pressure.
Peer pressure.
Yeah, but most of us in the industry, or some of us who used to be in the industry, I guess all I can say is when I was in it, we had a lot more self-control. The percentage of people doing steroids was really low.
So it was low?
It was low. Like, if there was a team of like 12, let's say, maybe one or two people would be doing it. Mm-hmm. Everyone else would be more into the physical aspect of it.
That's interesting. Recently, a number of wrestlers have died from drug-related causes. The biggest shock to me being Eddie Guerrero, who has, according to his widow, died from his past alcohol abuse and drug abuse combined with his, you know, aggressive workout regimen. Mm-hmm. I mean, what toll does this take on the body?
Well, the toll it takes on the body is if he's doing drugs and alcohol and he's stupid enough to do steroids, then, you know, it's going to take a big toll on your body. You know, I never really liked Eddie Guerrero in the first place, you know.
Well, I would bet that you and Eddie Guerrero have a lot in common.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, I mean, let's start it like this. Several wrestlers like Hulk Hogan, Jesse the Body Ventura, Scott Raven, they all have admitted.
So?
They have admitted. These are big names. So for smaller wrestlers.
So what does that have to do with me? It has nothing to do with me in my case.
I find it interesting that in 3 months' time, you've lost more than 100 pounds, and you're going to tell us that that's not steroid.
It's not. It's from a diet. A good, steady diet, when you work hard, you get rewards. I lost 110 pounds in 3 months. That's my reward.
And that's not a good, steady diet like Eddie Guerrero's?
Look, I don't know what you're trying to say, but I've never done steroids a day in my life.
You've never done steroids a day in your life?
Never. And you could look at me right now and believe it.
Well, this is not for me. This is for Brooklyn. And you've heard it here, Brooklyn. He says he's never taken steroids a day in his life. How do you explain the fact that, I mean, to be in the WWE, that most of these wrestlers are about twice your size? You mean that you haven't tried to compensate to get to their level? You can't do that. I mean, any normal human can do that.
Well, before there were steroids, answer me this question. Before there were steroids, how did people get big? Okay. How were bodybuilders? How were we wrestling?
I know.
Tell me.
Spedekate, this is possible. Definitely, we're going to use this next time. But thank you, Brooklyn, for joining us. We'll be here next week. Check us out on Let's Talk Brooklyn. I'm your host, Justin Holmes. Peace out.